Hi, welcome to Pendragon Woodcraft. Today I'm going to be making a lidded box, trinket box, out of a piece of spalted beech. So if you fancy watching that, please stick around and we'll see what we come up with. First job is to actually get the blank square on all sides so that we can actually mark an octagon out on it. It needs to be square, otherwise the octagon won't be true. I'll be cutting this octagon basically using this part here, getting rid of this knot. So next thing to do is actually mark out the octagon shape and then cut it on the bandsaw. First we'll find the centre. Use a compass to actually scribe round a circle. Now using a 45 degree square, I can actually mark across the corners and then hopefully all eight sides should be equal. What we do basically is we'll be using a 45 degree angle and we'll be marking across the tangent of the circle. Right, I'll just measure these with a vernier scale. That all checks out. Now to the bandsaw.
I've adjusted the bed of the bandsaw to 45 degrees to actually cut these corners off. Important to get this centre bang on, because it will affect the sides of the octagon when it's actually turned between centres on the lathe. Now I'm cutting a tenon on both ends for the sea jaws. The next task is to split this blank into a 3/5, 2/5. So I'm using the bandsaw to cut it, perfectly safe on the, because the sides are flat, none of it is round. Start shaping the underside of the top of the box. I'm using a 3/8 bowl gouge. Lathe speed's about 1700. So marking the inside diameter for the tenon off the base. Just a small amount of hollow end out on the lid. Using the negative rake scraper now. and now using a pointing tool to actually cut the inside of the recess. It's important it's parallel to the lathe bed. Working through the grits now, starting at 120, and we're going 180, 240, 320 and 400. Now some cellulose sanding sealer, followed by microcrystalline wax. The abrasive wax is first though, this will be followed by microcrystalline wax. Right, the next task is to start on the base and cut the tenon to make a jam chuck so that I can actually finish off the top now. Create bowl gouge just to get the end square again. Now using a parting tool to cut down to the tenon size to make a jam chuck for the lid. Create bowl gouge again to start shaping the actual top. Now 3/8 spindle gouge. Just getting rid of some of the waste. Thank you. That's using a 0.2 mm to deepen the curvature around the edge of the lid. Just put the spindle roughing gouge in there to quickly get rid of all this surplus wood. I'll start cutting the finial now. Put the point tool back in again, using it a bit like a detail gouge. Bit of fine tuning with the skew there. A 3 mm beading tool, put a couple of beads on the top of the finial. Just removed the tailstock there and parted off the end. Just a little bit of tidying up. And again through the normal grit range. 180, 240, 320, 400. Cellular sanding sealer going on. That's the lid completed. Now onto the base. Pouring down with a forstner bit to a depth probably about an inch and a half, inch and three quarters. Finishing off the hollowing now, getting rid of the mark of the forstner bit in the bottom of the box. I'm using the mixture tools here. I've got some box scrapers, square edge scrapers, and a negative rake scraper. Shaping the outside now, after forming a bead just under the lid of the box there. That's using the 3/8 spindle gouge. Just finishing up with the scraper again. And once again through the grits, 120, 180, 240, 320 and 400. Cellulose sanding sealer going on. now parting the box off using a 2mm parting tool. Putting some sanding sealer on the bottom now, and then that's all finished. And here's the finished box. Quite pleased with the way it's turned out. I managed to keep the octagon pattern around the base there. I was hoping to keep it around the lid, but I had a few problems actually cutting this. It's spalty beech, and as you're well aware, spalted wood can be a bit punky and variable in actual when you cut it, and unfortunately it broke some of the points off. So I had to round it off, but it's still come out pretty well, and I'm very pleased with it. So if you enjoyed that, please consider subscribing, and I'll be back very soon with more content. Thanks a lot.